Hello guys, welcome to another video in my channel. In previous videos, we saw pivot points and CPR points and different types of support and resistance which we can use in day trading. In this video, I am going to explain different types of market days which will repeatedly appear in your chart. So you might have heard of these three types of market days, either a trending day, that is also bullish trending day, either a bearish trending day or a sideways day. As a trader, you must know about six type of trading days that will repeatedly occur in your trading journey. So the first one is trending day, that is bullish trend or a bearish trend. The second one is double distribution trend day. Typical day is the third one, and fourth one is expanded typical day. Fifth one is trading range day. Sixth one is sideways day. So I will explain all these type of days with some of the charting examples, and I will show how you can use these trading days and make profit in your trading journey. At the last part of this video, I am going to explain important and most profitable day which most of the traders don't share with the beginners. Let's start this video. Before that, don't forget to like this video and subscribe my channel. Please like and comment whatever the opinion you have about this video. So let's get started with this video. The first type of day is trend day. You might have seen these type of days in your chart. Trend day is one directional movement, either in a bullish side or in a bearish side. So what is trend day? So you must know, trend days only occur few days in a month. Trend days will be appearing only 3 to 4 times in a month. It won't appear every day. Trend days will come only 3 or 4 days in a month. That's all. Only few days, trend days will be there in a month. Market will be complete quiet on the previous day. If today is the trend day, then the previous day will be complete quiet. There will not be any big movement in the chart. There will not be any big movement in the price. The active sellers and active buyers will not be actively trading on the previous day. And narrow CPR days is usually a trending day. You might have know about CPR. You might have watched my CPR and pivot points video. If you didn't watch that video, you can watch that video in my channel, and you can get good knowledge about pivot points and CPR. And I also shared a virgin CPR strategy in that video. You can watch that video later. So narrow CPR day is usually a trending day. On bullish trending day, the day low will be almost near or equal to day open. How the bullish trending day will be? The market will be in an upside movement. So what happens? The day open will be almost equal or near to day low, and day high will be almost equal or near to day close. If you don't know about open, close and day high and day low, you can watch my candlesticks video and you can get good knowledge about candlesticks in that video. So on bullish trending day, day low will be almost equal to day open and day high will be almost equal to day high. That is, there will be a one directional movement. The same way on bearish trending day, day high will be almost near or equal to day open. The bearish day will look like this. Market will be falling. So what happens? The day open will be almost near or equal to day high, and day close will be almost equal or near to day low. This is how market will look like on trending day. So let us see this in our chart. So you can see here, this is a trending day. You can see how market moved in one directional way. Price was making a one directional move. Price didn't make any sort of reversal or retracement, and price made one directional movement. And you can see here, this is a chart of Reliance. I think this is the chart of 6th March 2021 or 6th February 2021. So you can see here, price opened here 1966 and price closed at around 1905. Almost around 60 points of move in single day. This is called trending day. So on trending day, market will move in one directional and market will have big movement. So you can see here, the open is almost or equal to day's high, and you can see here, the day close is almost equal to day low. So this is a bearish trending day. So how I can predict this trending day before the market opens? Here you can see, this is a narrow CPR. Whenever you have a narrow CPR, you can predict that there might be a trending day today. So another condition is, on previous day the market will be complete quiet. Let us see that also. This is sixth one. Let us see the fifth chart. So you can see here, this is sixth, the trending day chart, and this is the fifth chart. So you can see here, the market was complete quiet. There was no big movement. There was no active selling or buying happening on 5th. So you can see a complete quiet day on previous day. So you can see here how market was in a range for whole day, and next day you saw an arrow CPR and there was complete quiet day on previous day, and you can see here there was a trending day on 6th. So this is how you can predict trending day before the market opening. Let us see another example. You can see here, this is also a trending day. You can see a bearish trend here. This is a chart of 11th March 2021 or 11th February 2021. And you can see here, Reliance chart. This is a Reliance chart. And you can see here how price made a big bearish movement and one directional movement. Price didn't made any retracement or price didn't made any reversal. So you can see here you have a medium CPR, not a wide CPR. It is a medium CPR. And let us see how market was on the previous day. So this is a chart of 11th. Let us see the chart of previous day. You can see here 11th is a Monday and you can see 8th is Friday. And you can see on 8th, you have a range bound day. You don't have any big movements. You can see here price was in a range for whole day, but at around 3 o'clock there was a breakout, but still price didn't made any big movements. Price made a breakout and closed somewhere here. There was no active selling or buying on previous day, and the next day was a medium CPR day, and you had a very quiet day on previous day, and next day was a big trending day. So this is the first type of day. The first type of day is trending day. Trending day is the first type of day market will move in one directional. Let us see the second type of day. The second type of day is double distribution trend day. This is almost or near to trend day only, but we have some other conditions. You can see here how the double distribution trend day will be. Market didn't made a one directional movement from start. Market had a distribution here. Market made an initial balance, and you can see at the end also we have a distribution. Market didn't closed or market didn't made a low at the close. This is why these type of days are called double distribution trend day. On trend day, we have a single directional movement. Market don't have any initial distribution or market will not have any final distribution. But in double distribution trend day, we have initial balance and we have final balance. This is the first distribution. This is the second distribution of the price on that day. So trend day is different and double distribution trend day is different. So on double distribution trend day, day starts with a small initial balance called as initial distribution. This is called as initial distribution. Either buyers or sellers break that initial levels and move price to next level or new level. So this is the initial range. Price was in this range for around 10:30 till 10 o'clock. Price was in this range. So either buyers will break this level or either sellers will break this level and make a trend. If you don't know what is initial balance, you can watch three types of important support and resistance video in my channel. You will get good knowledge about initial balance and how you can mark initial balance in that video. In this case, what happened? Bears broke this level. Bears broke the initial low and made a trend here. And you can see day ends with a second distribution. You can see bears broke this level and price was in a trend, but at the end of the day we have another distribution. This is why these type of days are called double distribution trend day. The initial distribution and second distribution. So this is the first one and this is the second one. Either bears or bulls break the initial balance and make a trend, and at the end of the day we have another distribution. These type of days are called double distribution trend day. So let us see that in our chart. You can see here this is a chart of Reliance, and you can see the day started with the initial balance. You can see price was in this range for around 10 or 10:30. Price created an initial balance. So our condition is we have to wait for the initial balance to break out. So either bulls or either bears should break this initial level. In this case, we can see bears broke this level and made a trend. At the end of the day, we have another distribution. These type of days are called double distribution trend day. So the first one is trending day, unidirectional, and second one is double distribution trend day. We have distribution at start and end of the day. We have a trend in between the breakout. So this is how double distribution trend day will be. The third one is typical day. Let us see that in our chart. So typical day will look like this. You can see here price made a big movement at the initial hours. That means till 10:30 price made a big movement, and after that price was in that range only. So wide initial move due to news or events. So the first hour movement will be because of news or event. That means if you have any news or event on that day, then price will make a wide initial balance at the first hour of the day. That is, price will make a big move and make a big range here. You can see here in trending day we saw 60 points movement for whole day, but in typical day you can see here price made a movement from on and around 2170 till 2232, so which is around 60 points. On typical day we will get that 60 points in the first hour only. The initial balance will create so much big movement. So in trending day we got that 60 points in whole day. So this is the difference. So on typical day price will make a big movement, whole day price will be in between initial hour range. You can see here price was in that range for whole day. Price didn't made any breakout or any retracement trades and all. Price was in that range only. So let us see that in our example. So you can see here, this is a sort of typical day. You can see how big was bearish and bullish candles, and experienced traders know that this is because of the news or event. So after that you can see price was in almost sideways and price didn't do any movement for whole day. So these types of days are called typical days. So let us see another example. Here you can see there might be a negative news on 22nd. So price made a big movement at the first hour, that is initial hour, and you can see how price was in that range for whole day. So this is how typical day will look like. These types of days are called typical day. Okay, the fourth one is expanded typical day. Let us see that in our chart. You can see here this is the sort of expanded typical day. The expanded typical day will look like this. Initial balance will be wider than double distribution day and narrow than typical day. Price was in a range till first hour. You can see here, this is our first hour. Okay, price was in this range only. In double distribution trend day we had initial balance very narrow, that was breakable initial balance, but in typical day we had very wide initial balance. In expanded typical day the initial balance will be normal, medium sized initial balance will be there. Price will trade in the initial range for the first half of the trading session. So you can see here, this is our day's high and this is our day's low for that day. If you don't know what is initial high and initial low, you can watch that video later, and you can see here price was in that range for the first half of the trading session. You can see here price was in that range only, and usually in the second half of the session there will be a breakout. The second half at around 2:30 we had a breakout, and we can see here how big was the move. So this is why these type of days are called expanded typical day. So in typical day what happens, price will be in that range only, price will be trading in that range only. But in expanded typical day what happens, the first hour of the day will expand at the second half, mostly at the second half. This is why these type of days are called expanded typical day. So you can think, what is the difference between double distribution trend day and expanded typical day? In double distribution trend day what happens, in first hour only we will get a breakout, the initial balance will be very narrow, and price will make a trend, and at the end of the day we will have a distribution. So this is double distribution trend day. But in typical day price will trade in that range for the first half of the day. Usually in the second half there will be a breakout, there will be expansion of price from the initial levels. Either it might break from here or either it might break from here. So this is how expanded typical days look like. So let us see that in our chart. On 25th price made a big move at the first hour, and price was in that range 1115. Price was in that range only. This is our day's low and this is our day's high. So you can see here at around 115 or 130 there was a breakout and price has been expanded to new level. So this is why it is called as expanded typical day. These types of, if you saw these type of days, then it is called as expanded typical day. Let us see another example. You can see here, price made a bearish movement here. Price was trading in that range only till around 230 or 245, and all of a sudden price expanded from here. So price made a breakout at this candle and price made a big movement. So what happens? This was our day high and this was our day low. Price made a breakout at the bearish level. So this is how our expanded typical day will look like. So this is the difference between double distribution trend day and typical day and expanded typical day. Let us see the fifth one is trading range day. Let us see that in our chart. In trading range day, price will make a basketball movement. Price trades from initial high to initial low. Price makes an initial high and initial low at the first hour of the day, and price will be trading at that range only for whole day. Buyers will push the price to the initial high and sellers will push the price to the initial low. That is what is called as tennis ball movement of the price. You can see here, price made a low here, but buyers took that price till initial high. Sellers entered and you can see price made a low here at the initial low. So what happens? Price will be facing rejections at the initial high and initial low. Let us see that in our chart. You can see here, this is how trading range will look like. You can see price opened here, price opened at this candle, and price made a bearish movement and price took support here and price made a upside movement but got rejected at day's high only. Okay, then again price made a bearish movement and took support almost near to initial low and price closed somewhere here. So this is how trading range will look like. In trading range day, price will face rejections at the initial high and initial low and close in that range only. This is a sort of a day which is called as trading range day. The sixth type of day is sideways day. Let us see that in our chart. So the speciality of this day is, this day feels like active sellers and buyers refrain from trading. That is like active buyers or sellers are not actively trading on that day. They will be like, on that day they will be on leave, so they won't trade or they are not actively trading on that day. You can see here, on this day, 24th of March 2021, I guess the chart of Reliance, you can see here, on this day price opened somewhere here with a bearish candle and some people thought this is a trend day, but all of a sudden price reversed from here but didn't touch the initial high. So this is not a trading range day. Again, price made a bearish movement and price didn't had any one directional movement or trade vacillation on this day. So this day will be like, there are no active sellers or there are no active buyers on that day. This day occurs ahead of a holiday or a major news or event day. If tomorrow is a holiday, or if you have any news, or if you have any event on next day, then today will be a sideways day. There might be a good chances that today will be a sideways day. There will not be any active trading today. So this is how sideways days will appear. There will be no trading vacillation and directional conviction. So there was no one directional movement. There was no trading range. There was not even a typical day. There was not even an expanded typical day. You can see price didn't made any trading vacillation or directional conviction. So these types of days are called sideways days. Let us see another chart. You can see here, price was in the CPR for whole day, but this looks like a trading range day. But you can see here, price made initial high and initial low. Again, price made a bullish movement and took reversal from day's high, but didn't came till day's low, and price was in this range only. Price was in this range only and closed somewhere here. So this is how sideways day will look like. And there was no one directional movement, there was no trading range, there was no breakout, there was no typical day, that is like there was no big movement at the first initial hour. So this is how sideways day will look like. The last is the most important, is no trading day. This is most important. Most of the people think that you should trade every day. There are some days on which you won't get any opportunity to trade, which is also called as no trading day. Not every day is trading day. professionals don't trade every day. That is like if they don't find their system or pattern, then they don't trade on that day. That is called as no trading day. You should only trade when the circumstances are most favorable for a profitable outcome. If you see your system or if you see your pattern, then only you must trade on that day. If you didn't see your pattern or if you didn't see your day or if you didn't saw the system that you have backtested for so many days, then you should not trade on that day. So this is very important. Not every day is trading day. Remember that. No loss day is also a profit day. That means zero is better than minus. If you make a loss without knowing the system or without having your pattern, then it is a loss day. Zero is better than a loss day. So if you didn't find your system, if you didn't have your pattern, then don't trade on that day. So what happens in trading? Either you will hit a target, either you will hit a SL, or on no trading day you will go with zero. Moreover, trading is a probability. If you have your pattern also, you will get hit by SL. But if you traded randomly, then you miss the discipline. Discipline is very important in trading. You should know when to trade, why to trade, how to trade. So this is very important in trading. I hope this video gave you good knowledge about what types of days are there in trading, and now you can understand or recognize some of the days on your chart, and you can do some back tests and get good knowledge about some sort of days. Most of the people might had only idea about trending day and sideways days, but there are six type of days, and in sideways days also we have some of the other types. So this is the most important trading days you must know. If you like this video, please click that like button, comment your opinion, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. And thank you for watching this video. In next video, I will meet you with wonderful content. Till that time, take care, traders. Have a good day.